Hi guys, thanks for tuning in to another book review on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum, and today we are taking a look at Captured Weapons, or Beutewaffen in German. This is volume 9 in a series called the Propaganda Photo Series, produced by a Dutch publisher called SI Publicaties, and most of them, including this one, were written by a gentleman named Guus de Vries. I've always really liked this series of books because they're short. This thing is right at 150 pages. It is relatively affordable, as technical firearms books go, and it does a really good job of balancing really cool pictures with interesting history and a compact and information-dense writing style. These are easy to read, they're easy to flip through, they don't have the dense jargon that you sometimes run into in more technical books, but there's a ton of interesting stuff in every one of these that I've looked into. Now, some of them focus on a specific firearm. They have a book on the Luger, for example. They have a book on the Mauser K98. This one focuses on a type of weapon, so captured guns of all sorts. And the Germans had literally millions of captured arms that they used during World War II. If you look at just captured rifles and machine guns, more than 14 million procured and reissued and inventoried and used by the German military during World War II. So a tremendous number. That's not even counting pistols and submachine guns and then stuff bigger than regular machine guns. At any rate, what this book does is go through, well, I should say, the other thing that makes this cool, specifically when you're looking at German captured arms, is they were fanatically, obsessively organized about trying to document and categorize all of the different captured guns they were using. It's kind of what you would expect the Germans to do. And so they had a couple of basically index manuals, and they assigned a specific number, a designation, to every captured arm they got. And we're talking hundreds of different varieties. So, for example, if we were to consider captured French arms, they had a designation for the 1890 Berthier and the 1892 Berthier and the 1916 Berthier, all being slightly different. And this goes for every firearm that they captured. In fact, even down to bladed weapons, they had their own designations for captured foreign bayonets. And every single version got its own specific number, as you would expect from the Germans. So what you actually get is this really interesting inventory of firearms that were in use in World War II at the same time, because, you know, there are things in there that you wouldn't maybe think of as having been used during the war, and yet here they are being captured by the Germans, which says, yeah, they were definitely around. There are a few interesting little interesting side bits you can take away from this German inventory. For example, the complexity of the Italian variations on the Carcano led to even the Germans not being able to quite figure it out right and having some of the designations wrong and some of them missing. In general, though, they were really quite good and efficient about listing out all of these different foreign weapons. Now, the book, I mentioned, is 150 pages long, and typically, what these propaganda series books do is they spend about a third of the book on text, history of whatever it is specifically they're discussing, and then the remainder, photographs. It is the propaganda photograph series. This one's a little bit different in that it has first an introduction describing, you know, kind of what I've talked to you about so far, and then it goes into a series of 12 different chapters, each looking at a specific country that the Germans had arms captured from. So those 12 chapters specifically are Austria, Belgium, Czechoslovakia, Denmark, France, Greece, Italy, Netherlands, Norway, Poland, Russia, the UK, the US, Yugoslavia. So each one of those chapters is going to then have a discussion of the details of German occupation or capture, what it was that led to the Germans having weapons from that country. In the case of Austria, it would be the Anschluss, and they took over Austrian factories. In the case of France, it would be the armistice in 1940, and when the French surrendered, the Germans captured vast, huge quantities of arms and material. And then it talks about the specific arms that were captured in each country, where available, actual itemized lists of how many they had of this and how many of that, how many machine guns, how many different pistols, that sort of thing. And then a series of photographs of these guns in use. And that's a large part of what this whole series is really cool for, is those really interesting pictures of sometimes combat pictures, sometimes training, sometimes as the name suggests, propaganda, staged propaganda pictures. But in this case, particularly, what you end up with are pictures of a lot of very unusual arms in wartime photographs, in service, things you wouldn't normally expect. In fact, I actually caught sight of an RSC 1917 in this book, which I did not expect. One of the other specifically cool things in here is at the beginning, there is a section which is, so it goes from page 18 to page 26, that is a listing of all of the different German designations for captured arms. It's probably one of the most comprehensive lists of that sort outside of the actual original German manuals. So it lists what is the German designation, what is the original designation from whatever country designed the weapon, and any details that are relevant. For example here, just one at random, we have the French Hotchkiss Model 1922 export models, and they have three different designations, the LEMG, or light machine gun, 105F, F for French, 106F, and 107F, being, let's see, the one is a 1922 export model in 6.5, one is a 1922 export model in 8mm, and one is a 1924 export model. You then go on to the light machine gun 108SV, which is the Swedish model of 1921 BAR, and there's also the 109SV, which is the Swedish 1937 BAR. This continues. So, overall, what you're getting is this really interesting history of a side of the war that people don't normally focus on. Normally, if you think Germans, you think Mausers and iconic German firearms, and this is the other side. What are those 18 or 14 million firearms that were captured by the Germans? Who were they issued to? When and why? So, cover price on the book is $40 or $39.95. I have a link in the description text to their publisher, to SI Publicaties, the original Dutch publisher, and then they have a branch of distributors in various countries. So pick your country, US, UK, mainland Europe, wherever you happen to be. And I believe this is brand new on the market. I think it was supposed to arrive like last month. So if you don't see it for sale yet, check back because it will be in stock very shortly. Thanks for watching.